Four cards. Two red ones and two black ones. They make them that way at the factory. They have for a long time. Watch this. One, two, three. Four cards, eight fingers and two thumbs. That's a thumb. Just so he didn't get confused. This is trick there. The first card is the ace of diamonds. And I know the diamonds are Bill's best friend. Now, anytime you take one away from four you have, that's called arithmetic. I heard about that just this morning. Second card is the ace of hearts, the other red ace. Ooh, did you see it happen? How these two red ones turn black and these two black ones turn red. Do you know the names of the cards? You know the names of the cards, don't you? You know the names. Yes. What is your name?
My name is Kristen.
Good memory. Come here. Here's what you're going to do. Out of all the rest of the cards that are in my deck, I would like you to select one of them. And if you do not like it, you put it back and get a different one. This good? Let everyone see. Set it down. Now let me ask you, do you know what the divining rod is? A divining rod? Tis a Y-shaped stick made out of a weeping willow tree. Farmers used to use such rod to find water in thy fields. Here's what you're going to do. The Ten of Hearts, was that thy card? We're going to use the Ten of Hearts as the divining card to find yours. Come here, hold your fingers like you're going to pinch me, and hold on to the Ten of Hearts here. Thumbs up, thumbs up. Hold it like that. I'm going to go like this, you shove it into the deck, we're going to find your card. Hold on to it. Here's a card, the King of Clubs. No? Sometimes it's one off. The Three of Diamonds. What was your card? Nine of Clubs? Oh, it's that one.
Yes, it is.
Let me do one more for thee. Tis a fun one. I'll come out here. Oh, you know what? I needed to find this out. Did you ever wonder why she carries that behind her ear? Why do you carry that behind your ear, my dear? No, really. Why do you carry that behind your ear? Check this over. It's a little ball. No mirrors or trapdoors? No? Never. If I take this little ball, I just give it a little bit of a split there and out to it. Which one do you like better, this one or this one? I'll set that down. I will take mine, and I'll put it in my hand. You hold on to that one. No, let me show you how. You have to squeeze it very, very tight. Put your hand up. Watch this. One, two, three. Open your hand. Oh, how did you do that? Oh, you're so good. Oh, she needs her own wand. Back up just a little. I come out here and do this for you. This is done with some rope. Three pieces of rope in three different lengths. Hi there, wee one. How are you doing? Oh, I like your horse. Oh, that's a dragon, isn't it? Do you see my dragon? That's Luigi. He's my pet. Would you hold this for me? That's a short one. That's a medium length one. And this is a long one. Hook and tug on the rope. Make sure it's good and strong. Make sure there's no nails or trapdoors.
Good strong rope.
Is it strong? Is it good and strong? Yes. Oh, yes, you're lifting your head and it's dry. I see that. Watch this closely. Three pieces of rope, two different lengths, short to me even long. If I take the ends and match them up, because these ends are even and equal, does that mean all of them are the same length? No, because it's still short and long on the bottom half, yes. What about if I do this? If I bring the bottom up to the top, short, medium, and long. To where all the ends of my rope are even and equal, now are all of them the same length? Because of the loops. But you see with magic, the impossible becomes possible. Right in front of your eyes. Here's rope number one. Here's rope number two. And rope number three all the same length. Yes, you're allowed to applaud. But that isn't how I started this, is it? No. If you remember all those hours ago when I first began this. Yes. I'll refresh your memory. For you see, we started this with a short, a medium, and a long rope. I thank you so much. My name is Morgan the Magic.
Nine of Clubs. If you had said it in your state, we'd have one hell of a trick. Now I'm going to need the aid and assistance of someone in thy audience. Let me see who I can find. Hi, yeah. I'm busy. Come with me. Come with me.
be my new friend, Katie. Katie, have I ever done magic before? Katie has never done that. It's like this Pasco. Here's what's going to happen. I have a school bag. I'm going to do the trick first and then you get to do it. Aren't you excited? Heck excited. Do the best you can. For the rest of you, this is my magical black bag. Now this is not a trick bag, it's a magical black bag. For it is made out of some very special magical material. Now feel it. It's now felt. Now we're on the way home. You're driving down the road in the corner, you know what I just said. And then you'll laugh. Look inside the bag, do you see anything? Fish around with your hand. Is it empty? Reach in the bag again and pull the bag inside out. This way I can show everyone the inside and the outside of the little black bag. Turn the bag right side back in. Tug out the coin to see if this counts. For the rest of this trip, I have it in my pouch. It is a genuine, authentic 100%. You are allowed to talk to me. Yeah. But not an ordinary egg. This is a wooden egg. You know, I know it's a wooden egg. Because just this morning, I took it out from underneath a decoy. Those are the jokes, folks. Anything that goes inside of the bag will disappear, mainly the little egg. So pay attention to what you do this in a moment. Little egg goes inside the bag. You see the egg inside the bag? Yes. Let me ask you another question. Can you feel it through the material? Now, you know how they say we hide stuff up our sleeve. Would you check and make sure there's anything up my sleeve? Yes, there is. And up my arm. I'm going to make it sell, right? Yes. Now I'm going to make it disappear. I'm going to make it disappear using some magic words that I learned in church. Bingo! It's gone! No one can be seen. Okay, bang it right in front of everyone. What? It is invisible now. I have to find it. There it is. Do you see it? Good. Hold your front. Hold your hands open flat. The other way. Yes, it's easier to hold it that way rather than the back of your hand. Whatever you do, do not drop it. If you drop it, you'll never be able to find it. Yet it's invisible. Look inside the bag. Do you see anything? Take this hand, push around, make sure it's empty. Is it empty? Anything up the sleeve? Take the egg, toss it into the air. Good luck. Reach into the bag, take it out, show it to everyone. And now it's Katie's turn to do a trick. Take the little egg, pop it in the bag. Do you see the egg in the bag? Is it right there? Can you feed it through the material? Now face me. Do you know any magic words? Ah, I have some new ones. Repeat after me. You have to use your hand. Say nice and loud so everyone can hear you. Say, go!
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 No, 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 no. Keep low like that. Keep that little blow. Not the big one. Like that. Little blow. Just like this. Go. Like that. Vanishes into the air. She has accomplished the first part of this trick. She's made the egg disappear. Give her a round of applause. Now, when you see a bag, let's make sure it's not hiding anywhere. Look inside that bag. Do you see anything in there? Fish around with your hands. Empty? Hold the bag like I'm holding it. Fingers on the inside. Thumbs on the outside with your thumbs. Take a peek. I did not sneak anything in there, did I? Hold the bag very tight here. With this hand, they go to the bag. Hold it down here like you asked me for money. This hand. Hold it to the bag quick enough. I'm sure I have it now. Take this hand, reach into the air, and grab the little leg. It's bigger than that. It's a chicken. good mind. Hold it down here like this. Toss it behind me out. Look at everyone, look. He said, I don't see a gun. Look here, that head out in front of you. Go the other left. In a real loud voice, say, come on. Oh, she's a good kabunga. Take his hand, we should do that. We're going to give you a big round of applause. Someone, because I'm going to need someone's help on this. Let me see who I can find this. Oh yes, hand her your food. You can eat later. Come up here now. Give him a round of applause. We'll find out who we have here in just a moment. Yes, put your fairy contraption away. Yes, and in thy name?
Michael.
Michael, everyone, Michael. Michael, have you ever done magic before?
I have not.
You're going to be perfect for this. For the rest of these, this is a very old and ancient trick. It goes by two names. The ancient miracle of the Chinese making rings. Or, oh no, not that trick again. I prefer to call it by the first name. And with Michael's help, we're going to do something very special for all of these. on this healthy Christmas. We want to teach you how it's done. Pay attention. In my hand, I have four count and four salad. I was waiting for that to happen one night. Four salted gold rings. Well, they've been plated with this silver stuff to protect the gold. Four steel silver rings. This is ring number one. Ring number one. Where did you go? Oh, you're back here. Ring number two. Ring number two. Now, ring number three. And ring number four. Michael, all four of them. Love it. Let's see how well he's been paying attention. Can you tell me which one this one is?
Yes.
Very good. Can you tell me this one, too?
Two.
Look at your ring. Check it over from mirrors and trapdoors. Make sure I say this one, that is a good solid steel ring. Is it a good solid steel ring?
Absolutely.
Let me ask you something. Did you find any holes in the ring?
I did not.
There's a big one right here in the middle. I love that joke. But this hole is very important to the success of this trick. For if this ring did not have a hole in it, it would not be the ancient miracle of the Chinese linking rings, would it? No, it'd be the ancient miracle of the Chinese linking hubcaps. Tis a different trick. I'm going to take this empty space, and I'm going to put it inside of Michael's empty space. And for that to happen, solid steel has to go through solid steel. Face me, hold your ring just like this. Yes, pull this shoulder back just a little bit, this way. Yes, that way the ones over there on the cheap seats can see. Is this a good solid spot?
Yes.
Put your finger there, check it out, make sure. No one has ever done that. It would have been bloody. Do not blink. This is the closest I ever want to see this. Michael, you're not going to believe that it's happening underneath your nose. Solid to solid. One, two, three. Please be sure, everyone. That is ring number one. That is his ring. And this is ring number two. This is my ring. And yes, this does get a big round of applause. Now, as easy as they go together, they come apart. But you have to do it a certain way. If you don't do it this way, it just won't work. Come here, stand beside me. Pay attention because you're going to do this in a moment. Counterclockwise with the left hand, clockwise with the right hand. That's looking at it from our side. Then you do it together. You know together? Yes, that's like they're walking and patting your head at the same time. Then you have to blow. If you do not blow, they will not come apart. You have to blow like this. Hi, thank you. Are you ready? We're going to do this from the beginning to the end. This is ring number one. And this is ring number two. Hold them in your right hand. Hi, Vinia, thumb underneath. Do not do anything until I tell you. This is ring number three and ring number four. On the count of three, not before, I want you to hold one ring, let the other ring fall in length. Take this hand, these two fingers, grab the bottom ring and spin it. Very important that we spin the ring in this trick. You understand what to do? Have you ever done this before?
I have not.
Wash your feet. One, two, three. Spin the ring. He can give him a round of applause. First method to take them apart. Hold them just like this. Counterclockwise with the left hand. Clockwise with the right hand. Just do it together. You've got it. Blow. And they come right apart. Now, Michael, take the ring that's in their left hand. Give it a toss to the air. Take the left hand. Let it blink. And just spin the ring. Perfect. Give them another round of applause. Second method to take them apart. Hold your wings just like this. Spin the bottom ring. Reach through the top ring. Grab hold of the bottom ring.
Hold it with your left hand and go with your right.
Spin that ring.
What we have done is we've shown everyone that both rings are good and solid. Put them back over your right hand. Do it again. Spin the bottom ring. Reach through the top ring. Grab hold of the bottom ring. You got it. Just take it like that. Take it off. Take that ring. Touch it up on your shoulder. Take your ring. It's in your right hand. Put it in your left. Now the ring that's on your shoulder, give it a little push down in like this. Let it fall back in like that and just spin the ring. Perfect. Give them another hand. I must say something. Out of everyone I've ever helped me do this, I am the only one that's been able to get this far. They are doing grand. Last, the most dangerous method of removing two solid leading rings. Hold your rings like a bow and arrow. Tis perfect, but let's do one thing. Let's point it this way. On account of...
Straight ahead.
On the count of three, not before, this ring right here on your right hand. On the count of three, we're going to give it a hot spin. Here's what's going to happen. The ring's going to sail up. Right about here, it's going to melt through the other ring. Now it's free, it's loose. It is now traveling back towards Michael's head at about 10 miles an hour. Michael, this will kill you. When you see the ring coming flying at your head, throw your arms like that and catch it. If you don't, you're going to pop it before it's made out of steel.
Okay.
It will hurt. You're doing grand! On the count of three, here we go. One, two, three. Spin the ring, have it come all the way out. Take your ring that's in your left hand, put it in your right. Take your ring, pull it in your left, and you spin the ring. He did it faster than I did. Give Michael a huge round of applause. Take all four rings and give them a little jiggle. You create a chain of four. Take the chain of four, collapse it on there, and you're going to end up. Going to end. One moment. You end up with three rings on front. Just impossible. Let me see how all of thee have been paying attention. Nice and loud so I can hear thee. This is ring number. Four. Ring number four. This is ring number
three.
This is ring number two and ring number two. Say what? Tis right. Ring number one. The Chinese Linking Rings. Me lords and me ladies, your majesty. I am Morgan the Magi. This is Morgan of the Day. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Oh dear. Well, that was something. I got a Roxandra with a stick in her, and I got a stick. No, this thing is falling apart.
Oh, well, let's give it some cheers.
Let's do. Hip hip.